Never pick paramotor training based off of these two things. What are they? Everybody, so often people start looking for local training first, and they base things off of price and what they think is convenience. Oh, I just want to go to the local guy. Horribly, horribly bad plan. So it is absolutely critical that those are not the first two things or at all that you look at. What you want to look at is the best training. Who gives a crap if the guy's local if he totally sucks? You have to look at the skill of the students he's producing. You cannot just believe anyone who claims they're an instructor, because there is no license in this sport to be an instructor. So anyone claiming to be certified is certifiable. They are a flat out liar. They are a fraud. There is no license whatsoever. So automatically, anyone claiming to be certified, lying, total fraud, doesn't exist. So you can't just go, oh, he's got a piece of paper, he claimed to be certified, he must know what he's doing. You can't base it off of that. But that's like the most common thing. Hey, where are you? How local? How close are you to me? You don't want to look at paramotor training as too close, because the location that you train at is absolutely critical. If you're in upstate New York, you can't really train properly in Joe Blow's farmer field. Because if you're in the Spansky's field, where's the wind? How are you going to do your glider control? How are you going to get 25 to 60 hours of glider control into a 10-day class? It's not going to happen. The only place in the world that the wind blows generally all day, every day, consistently, so that you can actually get 25 to 60 hours of glider control in the 10 days and upwards of 530 flights, like Super Lee, who set the world record at Super Training, you have to have a beach location. So it's one of the only places in the world, and it's got to be a very specific beach, because you just take a random beach in Florida, it could be blowing offshore this way, that way. And so it's not consistent. The very specific beach, the location for training is so critical. We actually drive 1,500 miles from Utah all the way to a specific location in Texas to be able to use that specific beach. Because if we tried to train you in Utah, it would take a year or more to try and build 25 to 60 hours of glider control. It's not realistic. It just doesn't work. You can't learn in upstate Ohio. You can't learn in Iowa. It doesn't work that way unless you want to take a year or more. But obviously, an instructor is not going to spend that much time with you going out there to get 5 minutes of kiting here and there and the winds this way. So it's all about the location where you can actually get the best training. So do not throw out this idea of I'm going to get local training. Price is another one that people think, oh, I'm just going to have my buddy teach me. Or, oh, well, I can't go wrong with free training, or Joe Blow, who's going to charge $1,500. Bah! What's the price of horrible training? It's horribly catastrophic. It's your life. I mean, if you don't even count the medical bills, think about trashing the gear. You get some nice gear, and you suck your $3,800 glider through the prop. Well, if your training was literally free, and you just sucked a $3,800 glider through the prop, was that cheaper than getting the real training? No, you just spent way more. And that was once. You're gonna do it over and over and over if you don't get training in the right spot and get the best training where you learn real actual skills. Because every little oops and losing control, 2,500 to 6,500 damages. Whap, whap, 2,500, 6,500, bam, 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 money, 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 money. So Joe Blow idiot who thinks he's going to save money with free training or having his buddy train him, generally ends up quitting the sport because he just runs out of money and it's just not fun to trash gear and it's just not what he expected. So training is huge because it's the whole sport for you. If it's, you know, if you're trashing gear, it's not fun. You're just not going to enjoy the sport if you suck. So the value of getting the very best training in the world in the absolute best possible location where you can get the most possible hours of actual practice is worth way more than it actually costs. Not to mention super training includes lodging, plus we provide rental cars, plus we provide all the gear you train on so you're not beating up your own gear. Plus if you damage any gear at super training, we pay for it. So over and over I hear people, that is the nightmare. All local training, it's very common, but it is the huge, gigantic mistake. Don't make that mistake. And don't look at just the upfront cost of the training. Think about what bad training is gonna cost you over the long run in risking your life and trashing gear. Very, very important. If you get the very best training up front, it will save you a fortune and will most likely save the whole sport because you're gonna have a blast and you'll actually enjoy the sport instead of ending up quitting the sport, dumping all your gear for nothing, pennies on the dollar, because you trashed it all. So much smarter, much more cost effective to look for the very best. The very best training is super training, and I challenge you to prove me wrong. How do you know which training's the best? Look at the skill of the students. Compare the skill of the students. Heck, compare the skill of our students to other instructors. Almost no others acting as instructors can even do what our brand new students can do. Look at the skill of super students. Look what they're doing. Send the video to other instructors and challenge their instructor to try and do things like reverse kiting no hands or kiting up a vertical wall and perfectly controlling the altitude of their butt where they're showing absolute mastery of glider control, which is collapse prevention. Because if you can control the altitude of your butt, the odds of you taking a collapse drastically drop. That's real actual skills. So look at the skills, compare skill against skill, and don't take any crap, because it's kind of hilarious how some of these people try and respond. You send them a video of super students and you go, hey, show me a video of yourself doing that. And their response, most of the time they don't even answer because they can't compete with super training, won't even try, but it'll be just a pile of trash talking. Oh, blah, 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 blah. It's not about talk, like show me the skills. You either got the skills or you don't. Can you compete or can't you? Skill is skill is skill. I mean, do you compare a car to someone talking? Or do you compare this car and its condition to that car and its condition? I mean, you have to look at the condition of the students. That is the quality of the training, is the skill and the outcome of that training. So that's what you need to compare. Forget about the local or the price, because the price is gonna be the lowest when you get real actual skills and do it the right way. Hopefully we've been helpful today and giving you some things to think about. Let me know if you have any more questions. Give us a call. Let's go flying.